the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate the first Friday of this month, we all dedicate ourselves to the most sacred heart of Jesus, to dedicate ourselves, sinners, needing of God's mercy and pardon. And so as we prepare to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us implore the forgiveness by which we are all redeemed and saved. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conformed to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this, you who trample upon the needy and destroy the poor of the land. When will the new moon be over, you ask, that we may sell our grain, and the Sabbath, that we may display the wheat? We will diminish the containers for measuring, add to the weights, and fix our scales for cheating. We will buy the lowly man for silver, and the poor man for a pair of sandals. Even the refuse of the wheat we will sell. On that day, says the Lord, I will make the sun set at midday, and cover the earth with darkness in broad daylight. I will turn your feasts into mourning, and all your songs into lamentations. I will cover the loins of all with sackcloth, and make every head bald. I will make them mourn as for an only son, and bring their day to a bitter end. Yes, days are coming, says the Lord God, when I will send famine upon the land, not a famine of bread or thirst for water, but for hearing the word of the Lord. Then shall they wander from sea to sea, and rove from the north to the east, in search of the word of the Lord, but they shall not find it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Blessed are they who observe his decrees, who seek him with all their heart.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
With all my heart I seek you. Let me not stray from your commands.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
My soul is consumed with longing for your ordinances at all times.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
The way of truth I have chosen, I have set your ordinances before me.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Behold, I long for your precepts. In your justice, give me life.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
I gasp with open mouth in my yearning for your commands.
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Please stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your word is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus passed by, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the customs post. He said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. While he was at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat with Jesus and his disciples. The Pharisees saw this and said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" He heard this and said, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. Go and learn the meaning of the words, 'I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Jesus had a very special guest. Not those who would regularly go with him or listen or accompany him, hindi lang po yung mga alagad na laging nakasunod kay Jesus o laging niyang kasama, but tax collectors and sinners draw near or came to Jesus. And they came to Jesus hindi lang po para makinig, hindi lang din para makasama siya, pero para makikain at makasama ang mismong presensya ni Jesus. And outside the circle of this seeming gathering were Pharisees who asked the question, "Why do your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" Kumbaga, sa lahat ba naman ng mga tao, bakit pa yung mga kinaaayawan ng mga tao dahil mga naniningil ng buwis at yung mga iniiwasan ng mga tao dahil mga makasalanan? Di ba dapat yung mga friends lang, yung maaayos lang, yung may marangal na buhay lang ang dapat kasama ng taong ito? But we all heard Jesus answering them, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners." And my dear brothers and sisters, this will always be the same event in our daily life. Sa binigat o sa pinakamaliit na kasalanan, sa kinapangit o kinakomplikado ng sarili natin, hindi po ito hadlang para makalapit tayo kay Jesus. Mas hindi rin ito problema kay Jesus para isama at makasama niya tayo sa araw-araw na buhay. Hindi rin ito problema kay Jesus para pagbigyan tayo sa mga panalangin at kagustuhan natin. We might be the most sinful and the most miserable in this life, but we have someone to bank on our heads and seek refuge. Kung inyo pong ding titignan, whenever we would celebrate the Holy Mass, just right after the beginning, we acknowledge not only our blessings, but also we acknowledge that we are sinners. We recognize ourselves as sinners, but we are winners of the mercy of God. Totoo, mahina kung mahina na, may pinagdadaanan na, may komplikasyon sa buhay, tuyo ang espiritual na buhay, nawawala o nagwawala. The more Jesus is inviting you and me to come and celebrate with Him. This will not lead us out of the mercy and the presence of God, but our being sinners, our being frail, would all the more lead us and be the reason for us to come close to God. Hindi dahil makasalanan o matindi ang hinaharap sa buhay, bawal na sa presensya ng Diyos. Baka nga mas magagandang pagkakataon pa ang mga ito para makilala at mabasbasan tayo ng Diyos. We are sinners, but we are winners of the mercy and love of God. It is not only God correcting our sinful ways, making our days straight and smooth. It is also God blessing us with His love and mercy. Hindi po mapantaboy ang Diyos sa mahina at makasalanan na tulad natin. In a very special way, He wants us to be winners of His mercy and us enjoying close and intimate relations with Jesus Himself.
Please stand.
Christ came to call sinners, offering them salvation. With humility of spirit and aware of His call, let us bring our prayers to the Father. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may be seen as a healing home of the weak and the sinful, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who hold public office may be honest and faithful to their duties, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in this Eucharistic offering we may experience God's healing mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may look with compassion and understanding to those persons who are living sinful lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may experience the saving power of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and for all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, with the faith of Abraham who followed your call, your Christian people bring their prayers to you. Grant what you inspire us to ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
O God, the Father of mercies, who, because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with him, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, He gave Himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from His pierced side, the wellspring of the Church's sacraments, so that, won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Coming together as God's family with confidence, let us call on God, our Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Tomorrow, the 6th of July until July 13, our Manila Cathedral will host and will welcome the venerated image and the original image of the Nuestra Señora de la Consolacion y Corella from the San Agustin community, sa San Agustin Church. And tomorrow we will be having the welcoming rites at 11:30 in the morning, and this will be with us throughout the week as they prepare and as we join them as they prepare and celebrate their coming feast come September. We would like to invite all of you tomorrow and pray to this image of the Blessed Mother who will be with us the coming week. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,